First of all the students pick your English reader book and open a poem I cannot remember my mother. Before reciting the poem I want to tell something about a mother. A mother is the most adorable and lovable person in this world. Her prayers and good wishes are always there with her children. So students, you should always love and respect your mother and her thoughts. Okay, first of all I want to tell this poem written by Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, Rabindranath Tagore, popularly known as Gurudev, was Bengali poet, dramatist, novelist. Tagore lost his mother when he was a child. This poem, Cannot Remember My Mother, is about a child who does not remember his dead mother. Okay, students, this poem written by Rabindranath Tagore and popularly known as Gurudev, and he was Bengali poet. Okay, there, yes. Before starting the first stanza of the poem, a very truly lines I read: mother is the only person who is closest to her child. Someone has rightly said, God himself cannot be everywhere, so he made mother. Yes students, today we are going to recite a poem, I cannot remember my mother. I hope you will enjoy it and listen it carefully. Yes, let us start. First of all, before starting the first stanza of the poem, I want to tell something brief about the poem. In this poem, I cannot remember my mother, it's about a child who does not remember his dead mother. Okay? But the child perhaps carries some isolation of the mother's amaze in his mind. Okay? Yes, in this poem, I cannot remember my mother, about a child. Students, इस poem में जो Tagore है वो अपनी childhood की बात बता रहा है, जब उसकी mama जिसकी death हो जाती है, ठीक है, बाद में वो उनको कैसे याद आती है. जब उसने ये पॉइम लिखी है तो वो बड़ा हो गया है, अब वो उन बातों को याद कर रहा है, फील कर रहा है, और उसको जो उसकी मदर की अमेज होती है उसकी वो मतलब इनफेट हो चुकी है, मीन्स उसकी जो मेमोरीज है ना थोड़ी इम क्या हो गई है, वो डिसअपियर हो गई है, और वो उन बातों को याद करने की कोशिश करता है. ओके, यस, इन द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा ऑफ द पॉइम I cannot remember my mother. Only sometimes in the midst my play, a tune seems to hover over my plaything. Okay, what is the meaning of midst? Middle, hover, to stay close to something. Okay, in the first stanza, the first lines, the poet describes I cannot remember my mother. Only sometimes in the midst of my play. A tune seems to hover over my plaything. उसकी मम्मा उसको याद नहीं आ रही, वो कहते हैं उसकी मम्मा उसको याद नहीं आ रही. Only sometimes जब वो खेलता होता है. All the students know when you are busy playing, okay? That time you forget everything. And the poet feels, okay? Only sometimes in the midst of play, a tune seems to hover over my plaything. वो जब खेलते खेलते खेलने में वो इतना बिजी हो जाता है कि उसको कोई बात याद नहीं रहती, लेकिन खेलते खेलते उसको कुछ बातें हैं जो उसकी याद आने लगती है. ओके, यस, इन द नेक्स्ट स्टैंजा नॉट अ नेक्स्ट स्टैंजा द फोर्थ लाइन इन द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा, ओके, अ ट्यून ऑफ सम सॉन्ग दैट शी यूज्ड टू हम while walking my cradle. Okay, I repeat these lines again. A tune of some song that she used to hum. Hum, sing with closed lips. Okay, what is the meaning of hum? H-U-M, hum. Its meaning is sing with closed lips. Okay. The second one is while rocking my cradle. Okay. Look at the picture. In this picture, what is this? The baby is sleeping in the. The baby is sleeping in the cradle. Okay. Yes. This is a cradle. Okay. While rocking my cradle. Okay. Rocking means moving silently. Okay. Rocking means moving silently. Moving gently. And what the next one is? What is the meaning of cradle? A small bed for a baby. A small bed for a baby. Yes. The child poet says that he feels the presence of his mother. At sometimes the tune of that song that she used to hum while rocking his cradle seems to hover over his plaything. Okay? The poet reminds and recalls his mother again and again, and he feels mother singing a song, and he was sleeping in the cradle. Okay? The next one is the second stanza. The second stanza of the poem. Yes, first of all, I want to tell, look at this picture. Which flower is this? Shuli. Shuli is the famous flower of Bengali. Okay? Shuli is the famous flower of Bengali. Okay? Yes. Now I recite the second stanza of the poem. I cannot remember my mother. I cannot remember my mother. But when in the early autumn morning, the smell of the Shuli flowers float in the air. Okay? The poet again repeat and repeat these lines, I cannot remember my mother, because he was totally forget mother's amaze, and he tried to recall memories of his mother. Okay? That's why he repeat again and again, I cannot remember my mother, but when in the early morning. Okay? Ab uski mama hai jo wo mar chuki hai. Okay? Uski mama ki death ho chuki hai. Okay? The mother passed away and he was very young. Okay? The poet's mother died when he was very young. Therefore, in the poem, he expresses inability to recall the face of her mother. Okay? On the other hand, he could only recall the tune that he shared with his mother in the happy moments. Okay? And in this stanza, the first line, when in the early autumn morning, the smell of the Shuli flowers float in the air. Okay? Float means spread. Okay? Phailna. The smell. All the students know what is the meaning of smell? Yes. Okay? He recalls the smell of Shuli flowers that his mother used to get to worship during autumn. The smell of the flowers together the happy moments with his mother. Okay? Yes. The fragrance of the Shuli flowers and the scent of the morning prayer service appeals to be the fragrance of his mother. Up in these lines, the poet describes the fragrance of Shuli flowers. Smell means fragrance. Okay? अब उसकी मम्मा नहीं रही, लेकिन वो फिर भी जब वो टेम्पल के पास जाता है तो उसकी जो मेमोरीज है, उसकी मम्मा के साथ जुड़ी हुई है, वो उसको फील करता है कि अब भी मेरे को याद नहीं आ रहा, लेकिन वो उसको रिकॉल कर रहा है उन मेमोरीज को कि कैसे जो जब उसकी मम्मा मंदिर में जाती थी शूली फ्लावर्स को लेके वहाँ पे पूजा करने के लिए, तो जो उसकी मतलब जो सेंट होता था, जो उसकी फ्रेग्रेंस होती थी. ओके? ऑफ द मॉर्निंग प्रेयर सर्विस अपील्स टू बी द फ्रेग्रेंस ऑफ हिज मदर. उसकी वो जो फ्रेग्रेंस है उसको उसकी मम्मा की मेमोरीज है वो फिर रिपीटली रिकॉल करवा रही है. ओके? इन दिस पिक्चर ऑटम मॉर्निंग. ओके? ऑटम मॉर्निंग. द नेक्स्ट वन इज आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन दीज लाइन्स. द सेंट ऑफ द मॉर्निंग सर्विस इन द टेम्पल कम्स टू मी एट द सेंट ऑफ माई मदर. Okay, the poet feels the fragrance of Shuli flowers and the scent of the morning prayer service appeals to be the fragrance of his mother. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस पॉइंट द पोएट फील्स अगेन एंड अगेन हिज मदर्स सराउंडिंग. ही फील्स हिज मदर इज सराउंडिंग हिम. ओके, व्हेन ही राइट्स दिस पॉइंट ही फील्स हिज मदर इज सराउंडिंग हिम. ओके, दैट्स व्हाई तो ही हैव ओनली फील्ड रिकॉलेक्शंस ऑफ अ रियल सेल्फ एंड ही वांट टू गैदर द मेमोरीज ऑफ हिज मदर. ओके, यस. द नेक्स्ट वन इज, ओके बेटा, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सेंट? अ प्लेजेंट स्मेल, फ्रेग्रेंस. ओके, यस. द नेक्स्ट वन इज द थर्ड सेंट, आई कैन नॉट रिमेंबर माई मदर ओनली व्हेन from my bedroom window I send my eyes into the blue of distant sky. What is the meaning of distant? Far away. Okay, in the third stanza of the poem the poet describes, I cannot remember my mother only when from my bedroom window I send my eyes into the blue of the distant sky. Okay, when the poet is in his bedroom, he looks out into the blue of the distant sky. He feels the silent, steady, protective gaze of his mother being cast down at him from her. Okay, heavily about her, his face seems to be spread all over the sky. Okay, in these lines. पोएट है जो वो बेडरूम में जाता है, वो खिड़की की तरफ से देख रहा है, आसमान की तरफ देख रहा है, उसकी जो आईज है मतलब मीन्स वो जो ब्लू स्काई है उसकी तरफ देखते हुए वो सोच रहा है कि माई आईज इन द ब्लू डिस्टेंस स्काई, मतलब मेरी आँखें जो इतनी दूर तक देख रही है. ओके, तो वहाँ पे वो क्या फील कर रहा है? I feel that the stillness of my mother gaze on my face. Okay, in this gaze, what is the meaning of gaze? Look fixedly. Okay, in these lines the poet feels silent, steady, protective gaze of his mother being cast down at him. Okay, her heavily about her face seems to be spread all over the sky. Okay, in these lines poet ये feel महसूस करता है, उसको ये लग रहा है कि उसकी जो मम्मा की आईज है वो पूरी आकाश में फैल चुकी है, स्प्रेड हो गई है उसकी आंखें, जो उसकी मम्मा की आंखें हैं, मीन्स वो उसको स्टेडली उसको वॉच कर रही है, उसको देख रही है कि मीन्स जब वो विंडो की तरफ बैठता है और वहाँ पे वो ये फील करता है कि यहाँ पर उसकी मम्मा है जो उसको देख रही है. तो पोएट है उसको अपने आप में फील करता है कि मैं अपनी मम्मा को देख रहा हूँ और मेरी मम्मा भी मेरे को देख रही है. स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर अंडरस्टूड द ऑल आर एंजॉय द पोएम. ओके, एंड अंडरस्टैंड द ऑल द एक्सप्लेनेशन. इन दिस पोएम पोएट डिस्क्राइब द फीलिंग्स. ओके, उसकी मम्मा जब वो छोटा होता है तब उसकी मम्मा जो उसकी डेथ हो चुकी है, अब वो बड़ा हो गया है, राइटर बन गया रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर. इट्स अ ट्रूली फीलिंग. ओके, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर की जो मदर है वो बहुत छोटा था जब उसकी मामा की डेथ हो जाती है, तो उन्होंने जो भी फीलिंग्स लिखी है वो ट्रूली फीलिंग्स हैं. और ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स नो मदर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पर्सन इन योर लाइफ. ओके, आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स, यू शुड लव योर मदर, रिस्पेक्ट योर मदर एंड रिस्पेक्ट हर आइडियाज and thoughts and always help your mother. Okay students, thank you very much. I hope you all are enjoy the poem.